So far we discussed the stream ciphers that are broken, and now it is time to talk about lightweight stream ciphers that are not broken yet, but we believe that they are secure so far. So let's first talk about Salsa and its very in Churchill. We already mentioned that this algorithm was one of the finalists in the East stream, so not finalists, but it was included in the final portfolio. So at that time, it wasn't the standard, but recently it's we're seeing it in many places, and it's becoming a standard in a lot of places. So let's first talk about it. It was designed by DJ Bernstein in 2005, submitted to eStream, and it was included in the final portfolio. In 2008, a modified version is named Churchill. Actually, he designed a lot of algorithms with names from Latin dances. We also have Roomba and so on. So we mentioned that RC4 was a stream cipher included in TLS version 1.0, but since it was broken, it was removed from TLS 1.1 and 1.2 and so on. So there wasn't any stream cipher included in the TLS, but AES was the only symmetric key encryption algorithm as a standard. But Google said that they thought that they need a stream cipher, and they included Churchill in TLS communications by replacing RC4. And since this is just a stream cipher but not an authenticated encryption, they also included Poly 1305. So when they're combined, it becomes an authenticated encryption. And Google added it to their TLS communication. So people might wonder why this is the case, because AES is really fast. Why do we need Churchill in TLS communication? The thing is that, probably I already mentioned in block ciphers, but it is a good time to remember. CPUs from 2010 from Intel and AMD come with AES hardware instruction sets that we call AES NIV instructions, or shortened as AES-NI. So in the software, it is really fast to perform AES encryption because the CPU has hardware level instructions for AES encryption. So Churchill would not outperform AES in these kind of situations, but not every CPU has these new instruction sets, because nowadays we are using tablets and mobile phones for internet communication too. So this choice actually favors them. This way you can use less battery power for encryption, because ARM processors in these devices currently do not have hardware instruction set for AES. But as far as I know, in the future we will see ARM processors with hardware level instructions for AES. So Google made such a choice. Then OpenSSH also adopted these algorithms, and they are also used in random number generators for the following operating system, like FreeBSD, OpenBSD, NetBSD, and DragonflyBSD. And it is also used in Churchill 20, used in Linux kernels to generate data for non-blocking, this URandom device. Then IETF published a reference implementation for Churchill 20 in RFC 7539. I say modified because the constant size or the known size are different from the general definition. But use of Churchill 20 in IKE and IPsec have been proposed for standardization in RFC 7634. And use in TLS have been proposed for standardization in RFC 7905. And Churchill 20 is also used by the WireGuard VPN protocol, and so on and so forth. But most importantly, this proposal for TLS became standard at TLS version 1.3. So actually I was expecting the winner of one of the winners of Caesar cipher will be included in TLS 1.3 as the authenticated encryption algorithm. But instead of that, they chose ChaCha and together with Poly 13 and 5. So its general design is something like this. The internal state, actually, this is the initial state. So we see it like an AES representation. It is a 4x4 matrix, but in this case, they are not bytes, but they are 32-bit words. So the internal state is much larger than the block size of AES. So initial state is filled with constants at the top. You put your key here. Then you have two variables called position and nonce. And of course, it depends on the definition. You can also use this part as nonce in some specifications, but I think this is the general definition. So we perform round operations on this initial state. At odd runs, we perform the round function operation on columns. So we take the column as input to this round function, perform the operations, then also do it for the second column, third, and the fourth. But at even runs, we perform the same operations at rows. And we call this operating on a column or a row is referred to as a quarter round because you're performing the same operation four times. And this quarter round is pictured like this. So for instance, let's say that we are at an odd round. So we perform on columns. So assume that we took this column, which is 32-bit words, but four many. So these four 32-bit words are put here. Then you perform this operation. But you also do it for this, this, and this, and so on. So this operation is repeated. Since the name is ChaCha 20, you do it 20 times, but different versions are available. So this is kind of a parameter. It depends on your choice. So this operation is just a quarter round. You copy the picture four times, and one quarter round take this input, the second one this, third one is, and fourth one is this. But at the even rounds, now instead of columns, you take the rows as input and put them here. So that is the basic idea. Then the output final state is XORed with the plaintext and so on. So we said that there are two lightweight standards in ISOS standards. One of them was Enocoro and the other one is Trivium. So I will briefly mention what they are. Enocoro was designed by Watanabe, Idaguchi, Kitahara, Muto, Furuichi, and Kaneko in 2008. It is a hardware-oriented stream cipher. Its design is similar to Panama, a pseudo-random number generator by Yuan Damon and Club, which was designed in 1998. So it was actually a hash function. Enocoro supports two key sizes, 80 bit and 128 bits. And in the eStream, they say that Enocoro 80 can be implemented with, they are compared with the eStream profile 2 candidates, and they say that Enocoro 80 can be implemented with 2.7 kilogates in ASIC. So a round function of Enocoro is like this. So this BIs are actually the buffer, and A0 and A1 are just 2-byte values, which is actually the internal state. We have an 8x8 SBox here, and this L operation is just a matrix multiplication. It is a 2x2 matrix. So this is just an update function of the stream cipher. And as far as I know, in the standard, we perform this operation 40 times as the round operation. And the output is produced from A1, which is a single byte. So this stream cipher produces a byte as an output in a single run. So some people always think that stream ciphers produce bits, but as an example here, it produces a byte. So in their documentation, the authors compare their design with other algorithms, and they show how much cycle per byte they need. Here, the lower is better. as you can see, Trivium is really fast. And they also compare their hardware implementations with others here, and they show the area it requires. But of course, as I mentioned this a lot in this course, comparing different technologies is not, is not an easy task, but still they got good results. So this is how they present it here. Finally, let's talk about Trivium. We said that it was another algorithm that was included in the final portfolio of eStream competition. It was designed by Christophe Decanier and Bart Prenel in 2006. It's a stream cipher construction inspired by block cipher design principles. I will not go into details, but this picture is very famous and it shows how it works. So I think it has an internal state of 288 bits. So these are actually bits that are included in the internal state. But every cycle you just rotate it like this and perform this XOR operations and so on. So you shift everything and produce a one bit output at the end. So these are Trivium and Enocoro are the two lightweight stream ciphers that are included in the IOSCL standards. But as I already mentioned at the beginning of this lecture, Trivium has only supports 80-bit keys, which I find really short, and it wouldn't provide long-term security. So although it is a very good design, it can only provide security for applications where you need the security maybe only for a few minutes or something. So for long term, it wouldn't help you. And as far as I know, people try to generalize this idea and have a Trivium with larger key size and so on. But then this those modifications does not provide the same performance or same security. So it's a good design, but as I said before, it is only good when you need short-term security.